Good morning, everybody. This is the video that I said I was going to make yesterday, but I got so much into dancing, having fun, cleaning my room. But I'm not going to drag this video out to get to the point. Let's get to the point. This video I want to talk about. When it's time, it will fall into place. So much things in life that we would like to rush, to hurry up and get going. And I'm going to try to take my time to talk because as y'all know, I'm ADHD. I'm very ADHD. My mind goes 100,000 miles per minute and I can end up talking just as fast as my mind can go sometimes. Let me do my best to make sure that I slow down when I talk so I can really get this point across. And I'm going to do my best to try not to cuss either. I really need to change that. That is so unprofessional. My thing is, in life, people want things. You know, people want to accomplish things. People want to do things. That's to be normal. The thing is, people don't know how to let it happen when it's time. A lot of people always are control freaks to where they feel like if it's not going their way, then obviously it's the highway. Or if it didn't happen the way they saw it happen, they feel like they're failing or they feel like it's not right. Sometimes people can get depressed. People can get anxious. People can get frustrated because things not going the way they want it to go or where they see it going. If you understand just how circumstances play themselves out, or even how just some things have to work together to make this next set of things happen, then you will understand that when it's time, it'll happen. When it's time, everything that is trying to happen in your life is going to fall into place. It's going to fall into place, fall into place, fall into place. And it's going to be so effortlessly to where you're like, wow, this was just so easy. Just fall into place that easy. You know that it was your time for that to happen. Now, sometimes some situations, okay, in life, you will never fully understand it. Just like you have when it's time, when it's right, it'll happen when time is right. You also have seasons. So you might have people that's in your life for a season. You might have situations that's in your life for a season. So many things that is in your life for a season. And when I say things are in your life for a season, think about the seasons. Seasons don't last forever. Let's just say we coming into fall. Fall's not going to last a whole year. After fall, you got spring. After spring, you got summer. So it changes up into the next phase of the next season. And that's the same thing with your life. Like you might have, like I'm going to use my instance for example. Obviously, y'all know I was in an abusive relationship. And it wasn't all bad. I feel like he helped me to get out of Baltimore. So even though he almost killed me, but he did not. So obviously it wasn't my time to go. So the time wasn't right for him to try to take my life or for me to die. I really feel like that guy was in my life for a season because I truly believe if I did not meet that guy, I would have never got out of Baltimore. I probably would have never ended up getting into trucking. Like it's so many situations that happened after that. Even though it was a rough patch trying to get on my feet after everything, things happen after something happens. So I feel like he was a seasoned person that was in my life for a season and he got me to some of the places that I am at in my life today. Like children. Like a lot of times people have children, they didn't mean to have the kids that they have. It could have been one slight situation that didn't happen to where if that didn't happen, you wouldn't have got pregnant or y'all wouldn't have had this kid. When you birth this child is bringing so much value to this world that I'm just so glad that the circumstances lined up with time when it's time. My thing is, the reason that I thought of this video is because in trucking, you will have so many, is the time right? Is the time, let's just use example, is the time right for me to leave this company? Is the time right for me to be a lease operator? Is the time right for me to become my own operator? Is the time right for me to get my own authority? Is the time right for me to finance a truck? Is the time right for me to just get out of, like there's a so, like get out of trucking period. There is so many thoughts that somebody that is in the trucking industry is trying to consider to either better their career or just be done with their career, that you really have to use this concept, that you really have to understand that when time is right, it will happen. You cannot force your hand. If you force your hand, it's going to get worse. I really want you to sit back and think about it. Just think for a second. Sit back and think. And I really want you to sit back and think about it. Every time that you force something, did it get worse or did it get better? And I'm not saying that it never gets better sometimes when you take control and you force it a little bit. But when you truly force something that you see is not working and you just trying to force it because that's what you want, has it got better? You got to let it pan itself out. You got to let it to where time is right. There's time for everything. There is time for everything. There's a lot of things that is not consistent in life. But one thing you can depend on to be consistent is the change in time. Just because you might not be in this situation right now, don't think that it can't get to a better situation maybe a couple months down the line, maybe a couple years down the line. Sometimes it do take years. Sometimes it can take a damn decade. But it'll happen if you're doing your part. And a lot of things is just decisions that we make. A lot of times people always want to do the blame game of companies, of people. Like they never take the time to take this finger and point it at yourself. Like one person said, well, everybody don't have the same circumstances, because I made a video called Everybody Has the Same 24 Hours. It's just up to you what you do with your time. So somebody said, well, everybody don't have the same circumstances and situation, but everybody has the same type of decision that you can make. You can even make a decision that's going to elevate you, or you can make a decision that's going to take you down. So Grant, the decision that you make, you might not notice a severe change as far as maybe positive right away, but with small decisions, eventually come big change. You have to understand this concept. You have to be patient. You have to learn that when time is right, it will fall into place. Well, I'm a spiritual person, so this don't apply to anybody that is an atheist and you don't believe in God. If you let go and let God, God will work it out according to his will. When you go against God's will, you are going against the grain. And when you go against the grain, God takes his hand off of you to where he let all the evil spirits and all whatever. Like you are out there in the wilderness by yourself to where you have to be responsible for your bad decision making, for your sin. Okay, and I'm going to just try to change it up for people that might be atheists and you don't believe in God. Let's go into science. Scientifically speaking, you got karma, you got the universe. Universe don't know good or bad. So whatever energies you putting into the universe is going to give it back. What goes around comes around. So if you spoiling out all this bad energy, you don't trust what's to be or what's to come, then of course you're going to get a lot of craziness coming because you're not trusting the process. Trust the process, boo-boo. Everything is a process. Just like me, I'm trying to lose weight, right? I'm trying to tone my whole entire body. Like, I'm really only trying to lose 8 pounds. I'm trying to get to my goal of 170, and that's what I'm supposed to be. Like, I'm supposed to be from 160 to 170 for my height of 5'7". That's what I'm supposed to be. It's a process. I cannot expect to do a couple sit-ups here, do a couple squats, do a couple jumping ropes, and I'm going to think within that day, I'm going to be 170 from what I am now. You cannot expect that when time is right. When I did everything I'm supposed to do, then that 170 gonna come with ease. Patience, baby. Patience in everything you do in this life. This lifetime that we have, you have to have patience. You have to understand the process. And you just have to understand that if you're doing your part, it has no way but to yield good results over time when time is right. One last thing I'm gonna say before I get up off here. Another reason I thought to talk about this, so that I worked for Epps for the Family Dollar account. Now, working at that Family Dollar account is not an easy task. This shit is not an easy task at all. And I'm sure I cuss a whole lot more because it's not an easy task, because it's frustrating, because drivers on a Family Dollar account, like, you think a truck driver get disrespected in general? You get like 10 times disrespected as a Family Dollar driver. You get disrespected by the store, the Family Dollar store managers every day. And it's like, apps want to keep that Family Dollar account so much. Like, they'll stand up for you to a point, but it's not so much they can do because they want to keep the account on the Family Dollar account. So warehouse disrespects us, and them store managers disrespects us terrible. And they might disrespect us verbally. They might disrespect us physically. Sometimes you almost have to get in a fight with these people. I mean, we get this. Well, I ain't gonna say we, because I ain't part of it no more. That's behind me now. So time is right to do what I'm about to do now. That's why I'm talking about it. But I ain't gotta deal with that no more. But them Family Dollar drivers get disrespected on the daily. There's probably a few drivers out there right now taking some disrespect as I'm making this video. I'm sorry for you, bro. Sorry for you, but I got out. I escaped the slave train, so I ain't no longer on the slave train no more. It is what it is. I really feel like the time was right for me to make decision to say, you know, I throw in the towel. I can't do this no more. And what really made me throw in the towel to say I can't do this no more, because I really felt like I was unappreciated. Then, like, next year would have made my year of being at Epps Family Dollar. I would have almost made a year. So I've been here for 11 months. You telling me within 11 months, I done changed into 8 different trucks. That's too many trucks for this job to be quote unquote a assigned truck type of job. I don't understand that. Sometimes some things happen to provoke you to make a decision. And I really feel like them, you know, messing with me as far as these trucks, everything else was fine. Like Epps, I really do feel like Epps is a good trucking company. But that Family Dollar account, man, yeah, you got to have more than patience. You got to be a strong person to work on that damn account. And I mean, I don't understand. But like I said, I just feel like it was meant for me to go through it with them trucks for me to finally make the decision to get my worth. Because I really understand and I really do know and feel like that I'm worth more than some fam working for some Family Dollar. Now, Grant, the money's not bad. But for everything that the drivers have to deal with, they need to pay them drivers more. If I have to do more than my job description, if I got to do my job, the warehouse job, the store manager's job, I need to get at least $2,000 or $2,500 a week instead of a measly $1,100 or $1,000 a week. That's chump change. So sometimes problems will fall in your lap to make you wake up, or it will be so many wake-up calls for you to wake up and take control and make better decisions. God has a way, or the universe has a way, of getting your attention to where it's time for you to make a change. And you have to be in control of your change. Because if you do not take control of your change, there will be no change. And you'll be a bitter person, always talking negative, always talking bad, always complaining, always full of strife, always full of negativity. But at the end of the day, it's nobody's fault but yours, because you will not take the leap of faith to do something that you know will better you or better you and your family. It's time to wrap this up, guys. I just want to leave you with this. When time is right, your time to shine is about to come. When time is right, it shouldn't be hard to try to do what it is you're trying to do. It should fall into place just so easy, so effortlessly. So if you get that feeling of, wow, this seems so peaceful, like this is just falling in place so easy, then most of the time it was meant to be. That is when the time is right. So all right, guys, you guys have a lovely day. And I hope everybody out here is learning patience. I hope everybody out here is learning self-love. I hope that we can love each other and not judge each other, because at the end of the day, I love y'all. And I had made a video, and the video was about, I almost got into a fight at the truck stop. And in that video, I was talking about I almost got into the fight at the truck stop, but I was saying it was with like an A-Rab type of guy. Of course, I gotta mention what he was. He was an A-Rab, and he was being ignorant. Because I'm mentioning that the A-Rab was being ignorant, I'm guessing other A-Rabs is coming on here thinking I'm racist, and I'm not, because I love everybody. I love everybody that's not. Now, if you are racist, I don't mess with you. I don't do racist people. I don't do crazy people. I do people that's positive and like-minded. I mean, I think because I said it seems like most foreign people give you the most disrespect, and sometimes it do be that way. I am not lying. I've had some bad incidents where I have got disrespected by some foreigners. I have. I'm gonna say all. I mean, I'm just giving my experience that a lot of foreign people tend to disrespect Americans, and sometimes that can be the truth. It can be the truth. I mean, I'm not saying nothing wrong. That's the truth. I wish it wasn't that way. And I love foreigners. I love everybody. But it's hard to like
and love somebody that obviously got hate towards you, is trying to hurt you. So I don't get it. I don't get it, but I'm not a damn racist at all. If anything, I'm too nice to people to where I need to stop being so trusting. Because one of these days, I'm going to pay heavily for it, for being so trusting. Then somebody wrong come in my life and hurt me or mine. So I got to stop being so trusting to so many people that don't deserve my trust. So, all right, guys, let me put this video together. Let me edit it and get my butt to the gym. So when time is right, a sister can have her 20-pack on her motherfucking stomach, shawty. When time is right, I get that 8 pounds up off this body. All right, y'all, I'm out. Let's love each other, not judge each other, shawty. All right, y'all, I might. I don't know if I can do it. But I might attempt to do the hot chip challenge. I'm scared. I don't know. Just leave a comment below how many of you guys will. Now, y'all probably want to see me do it just to see me suffer. Y'all like seeing me suffer. I realize that some of y'all on here like seeing me suffer. A lot of my supporters don't. But all these other motherfuckers, y'all like to see a sister go through some mess. But yeah. All right, y'all. I'm out.